never seen anything like this. The first thing that came to mind was the wormhole machine from the movie Contact. I get a lot of comments on my free energy generator video that claim that they have built a working system, so that's nothing new. But this guy actually invited me and was willing to share his technology with me. But when I googled his name, there it was. Reports of an FBI investigation. Inventor of free energy machine, a fraud. But when I did more research, I found that he has patents for his machines almost everywhere in the world. And the more I thought about it, the stranger it seemed that 60 agents would show up for an investigation of a small town inventor. I would expect that perhaps to capture the boss of a drug cartel, but for a simple fraud case, that seems a bit excessive. On a whim and against all advice from friends, I booked a flight to Oklahoma City. Kind of ironic, I'm in one of the top oil and gas producing states of the country, visiting a green energy inventor. This is one of Wayne's machines, but let's start a little further back. In 2005, Wayne decided to improve the efficiency of one of his bucket brigade machines. Except he doesn't do anything half-assed, so his project was two stories tall. But before we go over the details of these machines, it is very important to understand the fundamentals. So let me first demonstrate the key principles and discoveries from Wayne. There are many ways how you can use gravity to generate electricity, but for this simple example, I just bought a bicycle generator and added a pulley to it. As expected, 60 pounds produces more energy than 10 pounds. And if you're one of those people that acts like a 15-year-old that just had a thermodynamics lecture and now thinks he knows everything, hold your horses and wait until you see this before you leave me a comment like,
"You don't even know the first thing about thermodynamics."
If you are on the moon, it takes less effort or energy to pick up 10 pounds due to the gravitational pull being relatively weak compared to Earth's. It's about 1/6 of the gravity on Earth, and therefore you can lift 60 pounds on the moon with the effort it would take to lift 10 pounds on Earth. So if you pick up 60 pounds on the moon, fly back to Earth and then drop it here, you create energy for 50 pounds. 60 pounds minus the 10 pounds of work you put in. So far, no magic. I think everybody can agree that is how it works. Except, the moon is not exactly around the corner. So let's see how we can do something like that without having to fly to the moon. This is Wayne's light bulb moment. According to him, he was in a hot tub playing with ducks.
Cups. Playing with cups.
I have a little setup here to recreate and demonstrate what he discovered. The Y splitter here is so that we get the same amount of air on both sides. One cup is completely empty, and one is with a concrete block. I put 100 grams of weight on top of each of the cups. It's all about Archimedes' principles and buoyancy. Now when I push air in it, you can see that the cup that is partially filled with concrete is lifting up first. That means that I have to put in less work on the side of the concrete to lift the same weight. The reason for this is that only the surface area and the force or pressure pushing against it matters and not the volume. It takes more input to fill up the complete cup with air to get to the same pressure as with the smaller chamber. Wayne's idea is to use the difference between the two, so basically the leftover energy. This really is the difference between his system and an over-unity system. Over-unity would be lifting and dropping under the same conditions and trying to make more energy. To demonstrate this even better, I add another 50 gram to the top, and you can see that it still lifts faster and with less input than the side with the cup that is completely empty. And just like in the moon example, it takes less effort to lift the same weight. How is that for conservation of energy? I'm still pumping air into one side while the weight on the other side already fell off. If you question this experiment at all and think that I'm faking something here, it's very easy to recreate at home yourself. You know, just don't kill Nemo. Now, just like in that moon example, how do you transfer that energy? How do you switch between low and high gravity states? And by the way, the same conditions of course apply during the sinking process, as you can see Wayne explaining in this short video here.
We don't have to do a reset process like in standard buoyancy. We don't have to vent the system, sink it, and then fill it back up. We can immediately lower the pressure inside compared to the atmospheric pressure and do work in the other direction. Okay? You see that? And the same process works where we can change the elevation of our output system to do that, and so on.
But before we get into how to switch between input and output state, you may wonder, just like I did, why did Wayne decide to share this technology with me for a YouTube video? So when I asked him, he said,
"As you know from my FBI investigation, some people are very interested in silencing me. I kept a low profile, finished my development, filed all my patents, and now I want to share publicly. It is much harder to make someone disappear that is in the public eye."
He said, "I'm not that afraid that they will take me out, but more so that they ruin me and my family financially." I told Wayne, "Well, your timing is perfect, because today's technology is on your side. You can skip over this part, unless you work for the FBI, then you may want to pay real good attention." Here's what we did. We turned all of Wayne's information, drawings, specifications, and detailed instructions into an NFT. The NFT data is stored on the blockchain on a decentralized network and cannot be deleted. Then we set up a distribution list of all the people that should receive this information, including international publications and organizations. We then programmed a smart contract with an Oracle as the interface between the real world and the digital smart contract. The way it works: Wayne has a given time frame, I won't tell you how long, but let's assume 30 days to transfer funds from his wallet address to another wallet address also in his possession. At this point, he can convert it back to US dollars and use it for whatever he needs it for. The transfer is used only as a switch, first to make sure Wayne is alive and second he still has liquid funds. Once the transfer is confirmed, the timer resets and starts ticking again for another 30 days. If the timer times out without any transfer, all information is automatically sent to everyone on the distribution list. So that way, all the knowledge that Wayne has collected over the years with his experiments gets preserved and not lost. Back to the video. Now, the difference in our fish tank example is not as extreme as the difference between Moon and Earth's gravity, of course, but definitely enough to produce energy. And it can also be influenced by using different liquids with different liquid densities. Wayne had to find out the hard way that some of these liquids don't mix too well. What you see here is the result of a leaking chamber. The two liquids mixed and formed this jello-like substance. It was quite a setback for him and the team. It took them weeks to clean it all up and get it set up for testing again. Wayne is building this amazing machine since over 12 years. Here is just a fraction of his trials and errors that finally got him to where he is now. This is a little model of what a power station looks like. What you see here are all prototypes and proof of concept. And the best of each prototype was then combined into the final commercial model. Some people even asked him if he's building space cannons. We thought it would be ideal for a Star Wars photo shoot. Oh, and about that FBI investigation. After 2 years of zero proof, the FBI returned everything, apologized, and closed the case. I don't want to make this video too long, so subscribe so you don't miss part 2 where I reveal Wayne's final design. That's the same design concept currently used for the first commercial units under contract with a large German manufacturer. Thank you for watching. See you next time.